Insects as a whole are an incredibly diverse group and come in numerous shapes, sizes and forms, with more than a million described species being currently known of, representing more than half of all known living organisms. One characteristic that is shared with them all is small size, with the largest getting to weights of 70 grams, as is the case of the giant wester of New Zealand, which weigh in excess of around 3 times that of a typical house mouse. The Mimeridae, commonly known as fairy flies, are an example of this key trait of being small, with this family both including the world's smallest known flying insects and even the smallest on record, which will be discussed later, making them a truly remarkable group, and as such, push their established anatomy to the limit. Their name is actually a misnomer, as they are actually chalkid wasps, belonging to the family Mimeridae, with most species being less than 1 mm long, smaller than the average pinhead, although some do take the small size to the next level. Their fossil record extends from at least the Albian Age about 107 million years ago in the early Cretaceous, thanks to exceptionally preserved remains, and today are found in temperate and tropical regions throughout the world. They were first described as taxonomically by people in 1833 by Irish entomologist Alexander Halliday, originally describing them as the tribe Mimars of the family Chalkids, basing his descriptions on the type genus Mimar, collected by friend and other respected entomologist John Curtis in 1829. His other friend, Francis Walker, treated the group as a genus, and classified all the known fairy flies under it as subgenera. Walker, however, who was infamous for his shortcomings in systematic nomenclature, later conceded to Halliday's classification in a letter in 1839, and requested assistance from Halliday in classifying various chalkid wasps collected by Charles Darwin on his voyage on the HMS Beagle. Mimars, as well as the other tribes, were subsequently elevated to the family rank as Mimeridae by Halliday in 1839, with him describing them as the very atoms of the order Hymenoptera, and remarks on the beauty of their wings when viewing them under microscopes. The beautifully mounted fairy fly specimens of the early 20th century microscopist Fred Enoch are even among the most famous of the collections in the London Natural History Museum for the stunning look into a different, smaller world that is often overlooked, with them being especially popular among entomologists of the time and to this day. Mimeridae are the most basal members of the chalkid wasp superfamily Chalkidoidea, although they are far from not being considered diverse, with there being about 1,424 species of fairy flies known of, that are groups in about 100 genera. They are some of the most common wasps, but of course are rarely noticed by humans due to their extremely small sizes, being best distinguished from other chalkid wasps when viewed from up close by having an H-shaped pattern of sutures, known as trabeculae or carinae, below the frontmost ocelli and the inner eye margins. Their reproduction specifics vary depending on the species, although they are all parasitoids of the eggs of other insects, which has further implications later on in their relation to people. The effects of miniaturization is also very much evident when it comes to this aspect of their lives. Each fertilized female, the earliest steps will be covered shortly, can lay up to a maximum of about 100 eggs, searching rapidly for suitable host eggs to lay theirs into. Females will search rapidly for suitable host eggs by tapping their antennae over stems or barks of plants. Once a telltale scar left by an egg-laying insect is found, the female will insert their antennae into the recess and check to see if the eggs are suitable. If they are, she will then thrust her ovipositor into all of the eggs she can find and then laying her own in quick succession, retaining contact with each of the eggs with her antennae while doing this. Once laid, the larva then feeds off the nutrients produced by the other egg they are encased in to develop, killing the other insect larva before emerging through a tiny hole in the egg's surface. It has also been noted that sometimes the offspring cannot mature if the eggs they are laid into are either too new or if the embryos inside are too advanced, as the former don't have enough nutrients, and the latter take up too much space and are harder to digest given their size. Fairy flies have 2 to 4 larval stages, all apparently without functioning spiracles or tracheae, with this process occurring completely within the host egg, also being further peculiar in that they are different from other insects that exhibit complete metamorphosis, in that they produce 2 distinct kinds of larval instars before pupation, with the first generally being highly mobile and the latter immobile and sac-like, although this can also be reversed depending on the species. Once hatched, their lifespans are very short, typically living only about 1 to 5 days, although access to food can prolong their lifespans and increase fecundity, and some species can resorb their eggs, retaining their energy further to potentially mate again and increase their chances of finding hosts. Mating itself occurs almost immediately after emergence, with each female being fertilized by only one male, with no courting behaviors being observed. Some males even possess suction cups on the end of their legs for clutching onto females. Once fertilized, the males lose interest in the female, and the female also loses interest in further mating. This is taken to the extreme in Prestwichia aquatica, where mating has been reported to occur prior to the emergence of females from the host eggs, after which the male then dies without even hatching from the egg they are encased in. Once their eggs are laid, they develop rapidly and can hatch in 6 hours to 2 days, with several generations having the potential to form in just a year. Their adaptations to become minute comes with numerous costs to their anatomy and is important in determining their morphology, physiology and biology, also leading to considerable reorganization of structures, affecting almost all organs and tissues. In the smallest of these animals, the smallest are even comparable in size or even smaller than unicellular organisms like Paramecium, even though they themselves are multicellular and are still capable of sight, flight and the ability to search for food and where to lay their eggs. Such modifications arise not only at the level of their organs, but also at the cellular level, meaning that many features of them also have to be reduced or forgone entirely to function properly. As an example, their circulatory systems are greatly simplified, with many having no vessels or pulsatile organs, except for simple hearts and short aortas, and even then, in some genera, they are completely absent, instead relying on diffusion, which is enough to carry liquids around their body without the need for a pump considering their size, as there is less of an area the liquids need to travel. Their nervous systems are also rudimentary due to the necessity to conserve space, with a relative of fairy flies being the genus Megaphragma in the family Trichogrammatidae, having one of the smallest nervous systems of any insect, consisting of just 7,400 neurons. For comparison, common houseflies have 340,000, and honeybees over 850,000. This means that they have fewer cells and neurons to work with to effectively live, and so there is then a given limit to how small the neurons can be, and how many can be clustered in the brain. If the axon diameter of a neuron is less than 0.1 micrometers, as is neither the case in these animals, it would be nearly impossible for them to relay information because of the high level of noise from sporadic ion channel activity. Similarly, sensory units such as the ommatidia of their compound eyes also have undergone a lower limit in their size and number, as with lenses below a certain limit, the wave nature of light would cause a type of image blurring called diffraction. As a result of these constraints and the space available on the head, it means they sometimes only have as few as 20 ommatidia, and with the lenses close to the diffraction limit, it means that spatial detail is nearly non-existent and instead mostly rely on olfaction for locating host eggs, as an example. Many insects that have undergone miniaturization have solved this problem by partitioning their brains into their chests or abdomens, but wasps can't do that due to their ancestry and anatomy, as they only have a thin connection between the heads and the rest of their bodies. Because of this, their adaptation for reducing space not only includes lowering their number of neurons, but something never before seen in animal life, that's being the loss of their nuclei. When these wasps mature from a pupa to an adult, almost 95% of their neurons are thought to lose their nuclei, destroying them through cell lysis. Nuclei, as many of you watching will know, is the command center of the cell, the structure that sits in the middle and contains DNA, replenishing the vital supply of proteins needed to facilitate life. Although Megaphragma and other fairy flies can still live a few days without them in a vast majority of cells, living longer in some cases than even other, far larger wasps, as well as saving space inside the already crowded heads. How they manage to do this is through their growth from a pupa to an adult, as at the final stages of development prior to the emergence of the adult form, the proteins synthesized during the pupal state carry over to the adult, with the proteins therefore being manufactured and distributed around the adult for energy, whilst the remaining nuclei burst apart, giving the neurons enough energy to function as long as required. Fairy fly wings are also incredibly interesting structures, appearing all shapes and with long wispy strands known as setae emerging from them, giving them a hairy or feathery appearance. These wings are structured in this way due to their small size, as since they are so small, air is thicker and more like a liquid, and so they essentially paddle through the air. Some species are also actually aquatic, with one species, Charophractus cinctus, using their paddles to swim underwater for as long as 15 days. Because of their small size, however, they have to exit the water by climbing up plant stems that jut through the surface, as they would not otherwise be able to break the surface tension of the water. Wing reduction or absence of is usually exhibited by at least one sex, usually the female of the species that searches for host eggs in confined areas like leaf litter and soil. It is also exhibited by species that inhabits windy habitats like oceanic islands or high elevations, particularly endemic species which are found in isolated habitats or are located far from the nearest mainland. In these habitats, wings would only be a hindrance to the fairy flies, so are strongly selected against in evolution. The very smallest of this group, of both the winged and wingless, are likely the smallest of these animals in general can get, with the smallest known flying insects being Kikikee Huna, which are only 0.15mm long, and the smallest insect known being Dicapomorpha echmipterygius, which are only 0.139mm. These latter animals, being the male wingless forms, are so small that they do not have eyes, their mouths being mere holes, and their antennae being spherical blobs. Four males, lined up end to end, are so small in fact that they would only just about encompass the width of a period at the end of a typical printed sentence. Despite their small size, however, they do have a large impact on people and our environments, as their dependence on other insects to complete their life cycle means they play an important role in controlling the populations of many other insects. They have in many places of the world been key in being biological pest control for a variety of crop pests, in some cases bringing down pest densities by about 95% in some areas, many have said pests being invasive, with many other associations remaining to be discovered. Despite their relative abundance, fairy flies are however unpopular among insect collectors due to the great difficulty in collecting them, and because of this, it is also hard to ascertain whether a given species is on the verge of extinction or not. All in all, I thank you for watching this video on these animals, and that you may have learned something new. If you would like to see more from this channel, be sure to subscribe if you haven't already. And with that, I'll see you next time, whenever that may be.